achievement and sense of frustration. Now these two contending thoughts are very, very important, and especially if you talk to the young students and the teachers, young scholars struggling to make careers in knowledge. Variety of debates and discourses are presented here. My job is very simple here. I have divided my discussion because I am not repeating the things which I have been saying, you know, in earlier programs, because I have done this kind of presentation so many times earlier. The last time we had it in Bhopal, there I portrayed the entire historical and other kinds of institutional developments and technology. This time I have taken two aspects which I am discussing with you. One is, what are the important crises in chronology? That crisis part mainly deals with the crisis of scholarship in chronology. The second part, of course, is what Professor Tilaka has read, that relates to the opportunity part of chronology. I will essentially start with the crisis faced by the discipline of chronology. You know, to my mind, whatever problems the chronology discipline in India is facing, it is not because of any other thing, but because of the crisis of scholarship of chronology. Your expectations are shooting up definitely, because we are getting very ambitious in terms of career on the basis of clearing one examination or doing masters or doctorate in one subject. But what is important is, what are the expectations from the ones? Are those expectations, are scholarship requirements are being taken care of by us or not? Then we can demand. That is my position. Because generally, I see two things very clearly. It is not the chronology which is in crisis. Chronology per se is very rich discipline. It is the chronologists who have made it work. At some places I find chronologists are getting richer, but chronology is getting poorer. So we have to understand that in this country, the problem of chronology has nothing to do with the problem of chronologists. That is the problem. Chronology is a discipline has its own, you know, range, its own idea, its own contents. Is how the chronologists are dealing with it, using it, utilizing it, expanding it, you know, all these things. So it is because of chronologists the problem is. And the problem is, again I am repeating, is that of, you know, scholarship. So what is the direction of scholarship? What are the important, you know, references when what we have when we look at the Western chronology? Of course, the debate is that, you know, Western chronology, we dismiss Indian chronology. Fine. What is Indian chronology? Is there anything worth Indian chronology that you have contributed? So I will come to these things and probably comment on with the help of some very important study. Since this session is slated in terms of title, future of chronology, I try to understand how the scholars have handled this proposition of future of chronology elsewhere. Three writings I come across. Three very important writings. I would not be referring most of the time mainstream chronology writing in my discussion. Because mainstream writing in chronology, the Western discourses in chronology, are hardly relevant at this point of time to Indian chronology. If you are asking about indigenous interpretation of problems faced by chronology. Those three studies which I taught, which caught my resignation because of the similarity of theme that I am handling today. The first is by Smith David, 2014 article, Wider and Deeper, The Future of Chronology in Europe, European Journal of Chronology, 2014. And when he discussed the crisis of European chronology, he is not talking about the employment things or other things. future of not being in the government forever. These two ideas are not handling because I would be using third idea and then I will connect it with the Indian situation, how this kind of consideration can be very, very important to take up in the Indian context, especially when we try to understand the future of the government. This book is by David Nelken. Fantastically written. When I started reading it, believe me, I couldn't stop myself after reading all 10 essays which are produced in Futures of Technology by David Nelken. This book has not been written in an ordinary way. This book has adopted a left-realist perspective, a post-modernist, you know, post-modernism approach to discuss various issues related to technology. Now, in this book, he says that what is the future of technology? When we take this debate, normally our discussion is divided, the level of our discussion happens to these three, four dimensions. Either we can talk of the historical and comparative debates, I think Javadar's paper takes care of it. I understand. Academic technology, status and children, that is very relevant, very popular. Applied consideration, Professor Tilakar has discussed. I would mainly discuss the academic technology, status, and from there I try to connect that if scholarship is still then, the future of technology automatically. Why I say so? A very interesting comment I am reading through. You know, long back in 1978, what Donald Cressy said in an article, please listen very carefully. If you don't listen, I'll ask you again. We are teachers. Sometimes we get into teacher mode. You know, he says, he's referring to his one of the articles that he's read. He said that what he had not foreseen was chronology would become more and more concerned with increasing the efficiency of punitive legal apparatus and less concerned with trying to discover the processes generating the criminals to be punished and the laws and personnel doing punishment. So he's saying, chronology is becoming an apparatus for punishment. This kind of chronology is a problem. And Cressy further said that chronology appeared to be favoring policy over attempts to explain crime and lawmaking, and he rather unceremoniously characterized the typical chronologist at the time as a technical assistant to politicians, bent on repressing crime rather than scientists seeking valid propositions. This crisis in 1978, that you have drifted so much into becoming a kind of part of the state affairs, assisting the politician as technician, rather than the original task of criminologist in exploring the criminality, exploring the finding the causation, developing the theory, that job of criminologist has almost vanished. And Cressy said that tragedy is the tendency for modern criminologists to drop the search for causes and join the politician. These criminologists seem satisfied with